He came from outer space to save the human race. A creature with a dream to entertain the children of the night.
Welcome to the Nomi Song, the Klaus Nomi Odyssey. Thank you for coming. Appreciate it. My name is Klaus Bernardo. I'm with Palm Pictures, and I want to welcome you all tonight to the screening and the after party. Hope you all can attend at the Gansevoort. And, you know, ever since I heard about this project, it's sort of been kind of a 6 degrees of Klaus Nomi experience for me. I suddenly started getting on the telephone, calling people involved with the film who would hook me up with someone else, and everyone seemed to have a great Klaus Nomi story and who knew someone else. And then I found that even my oldest friends, people that I knew in New York, who I never knew Klaus Nomi, suddenly had a story. And obviously you're gonna see some of that story tonight, and we're very proud to present this film to you tonight. There's a few folks in the audience that I want to thank for helping us put this together, some of our partners and friends. First off, Bob Alexander from IndiePix.net. Thank you, Bob. IndiePix.net is a new website for independent film. It's very exciting. Be sure to visit the website, IndiePix.net. A very special friend who's become a very special friend to me, Mr. Richard Barone. Richard, I know a lot of you know Richard. Richard has helped introduce me to a lot of you and give me addresses and phone numbers and things so I can call people and invite them to this. And of course, Richard performed with Klaus Nomi. His first New York City performance with the Bongos was with Klaus Nomi, so that's a great story all unto itself. Eric Gertler from Black Book Magazine. Thank you, Black Book. Black Book celebrates independent film and the progressive culture, and we're very happy to have Black Book in the Palm family, and thank you for supporting us tonight and helping put the party together, which you're gonna go to later. The film opens Friday, February 4th at the Cinema Village and at the New Art Theater in Los Angeles. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to the director of this film, Mr. Andrew Horn. Andrew?
Hi, first of all, thanks everybody who came tonight to see the preview, I guess, here in New York. And I usually, when I've been showing the film over this past year at film festivals or whatever, I always often start my talk by asking who in the audience knows who Klaus Nomi is. And in this audience, I think I'd rather ask who in this audience does not know who Klaus Nomi is. Anybody? And what are you doing here? So it's been actually sort of a long odyssey, even just making this movie. I've been working on this since 1998. And some of you I met in 1998 and have sort of followed me through the whole process, which was in some ways really great and meeting a lot of people, and in some ways very arduous and just the usual bullshit that one has to live through to make a kind of a movie like this. But I'm really glad to see a lot of people here who are friends of mine and who became friends of mine as a result of the movie, and also people, I hope, who will come up and say hello afterwards, who I only know through phone calls and through email, who I work with on this movie, who had to put up with my cajoling and pleading and begging whatever to get the kind of stuff that we needed to get the film going. So without further ado, I guess we can start. Again, I hope, thanks for coming. I hope you enjoy the film. I usually also would say, I made it just for you, and in this particular case, it couldn't be more true. Please extinguish all cigars and cigarettes and fasten your seatbelts because we are ready for blast off.
The Nomi Song. Congratulations, Andrew.
Thanks a lot.
I wanted to ask you what you feel now in 2005 is the relevance of Klaus Nomi.
All you have to do is just watch him in the movie and you see that it's relevant. You just see that, you see people who are young people see it and they just get totally knocked out.
I love the way your film combines his story with the live performance footage that I've never seen before, you know? It's a very good balance.
Well, the really great thing about it is that he's just so visual.
Yeah.
You know, in a lot of these movies, there's always people who come and they're talking about, oh, this person was so great and they did this and they influenced me and blah, blah, blah. And in this case, you really don't need it because you just see it.
So I'm talking to Mike Thorne, one of my favorite record producers in the world. There was such a burst of creativity in the early 80s, the late 70s. Then it seems like there was, to me, a lull. How was there such a spark of creativity at one point with these characters who would just sort of blast on the scene? You know, how did that happen? Why? And why doesn't it happen now?
It was a very different social situation then. You could come to New York and live on thin air and dreams.
That's true.
And all of us did in our different ways, and all of us came through it in different ways. And what was wonderful was that the syndrome that a lot of people in the movie referred to, which is that you could come here and if you were brazen enough, you know that.
Oh yeah.
If you were forward enough and you just pushed it hard enough, then it would work. It didn't have to subscribe to any corporate values or to any pre-established artistic values.
Right.
And it's impossible for people to do what Klaus did and, as we did to a lesser extent, do what we did. Now, it seems to me, it's not something to weep over. It's just gone. It's a different time.
Yeah.
But it was a marvelous time.
And one thing I wanted to ask you, too, is how you felt about the film itself and how it portrayed that era and Klaus in general.
Well, Klaus was a singular character. This is an understatement. I knew him slightly, and we talked about production a couple of times. I thought him an utterly charming person, totally theatrical. A few comparisons with Nina Hagen, with even Mark Almond, and then latterly Bronski Beat and the Communards. All friends and associates, obviously.
Yes, of course. You know, I must say, must add one thing, is that I really wish you would have been able to produce a record with Klaus, because I think you would have made the definitive Klaus Nomi album.
Well, that's a nice thought, and it would have been a very challenging project. But the business side really was a little bit pear-shaped at the time.
Of course, I know how that is.
And also the other thing about somebody with Klaus's dramatic persona, it needs a certain amount of production resources. We saw him singing an operatic aria in front of what looked like a full orchestra.
Yeah.
That cost money.
Of course.
That money was not available for Klaus.
Right.
Except in a few exceptional circumstances.
Yeah. Thank you so much for the comments.
A real pleasure.
And you know, it's always a real pleasure to see you and to talk with you.
And you. And you don't have to wear that tux below 42nd Street, you know.
Okay, that's right.
We just saw the Nomi song, and Gabrielle, of course, is in it. And, you know, I'd like to ask her first how she liked the film.
I loved it.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. It catches in so perfectly. And there was so much more material. I think he could have made a film for 5 hours.
Yeah.
It brought back memories. Especially the first night at the Broadway. The beginning of his career, I was pretty much around. And later on, you know, I'm having a career in Germany at the same time. So I wasn't always here, but I was here in the end.
I adored it. It was wonderful. It was good to see Klaus again. I've known him for a long time, too. Yeah, off and on for about 20 years, too. I met him through Gabrielle. You like the film?
I think it's great. And I also think it's a tragedy that can be looked at in 20 or 30 years. You know, I've always appreciated him from afar, but I was amazed to see the range of his voice. And it's sad. I mean, it can only end in pain.
Klaus Nomi came in to my eyes and my ears on the same boat that Nina Hagen did. It was the first time I'd ever seen him move. Was in that film because I'd only seen photographs. And the photograph, he was camera ready, like they said. I mean, he was born camera ready.
Yeah.
But it was fascinating to see the actual person. And I thought his singing was even more, it gave you even more, seeing it coming out of the human being.
I did know him after I saw the film. It was really, you know, really a positive thing. And of course, I love Gabby as well. Because I love Gabby, but
Gabriella was sensational.
Yeah, she was fabulous.
cut, I just fell in love with the movie as a story. It was a very heart-wrenching, very touching story, you know. But then his performance takes it to another place.
We have David Evangelista here, and he just saw the Nomi song. So I was going to ask you, David, like, what your first reactions were to the film itself.
Oh, I just found it so, so creative. You know, it really inspires you. You know, it really inspires art, I think.
It captures a time when there was just sort of a free form spirit of creativity that was going on. There was not really boundaries.
And everything is just so stale right now. Yeah. And it really gives you hope that hopefully a new movement will come up again.
What relevance do you think he has now?
Yeah, I think relevance. I think really with fashion. I mean, it's just so out there. Yeah. That last scene with him singing the aria with his little Elizabethan collar.
Great.
I mean, the art direction was so good in the movie too, I thought. It was really, really great. It really captured the time as it was.
Did you know about Klaus Nomi before you saw the film?
No, I had no idea who Klaus Nomi was.
Wow.
And now I'm going to go on home and I'm going to Google it.
That's right. That's,
I swear I am. I'm going to go home, I'm going to Google it.
Yeah.
I'm going to see what records he put out, everything.
So, what I was going to ask you, Norman, was how you liked the film tonight and what you thought about it.
I thought it was beautiful. I didn't know so much about him, you know, and I mostly know him from people who have ripped off some of his stuff to sort of create personas of their own, you know, and like I said, I knew Joey from before.
Yeah.
Actually, it was crazy to see Joey so young and he's really awesome. I first met him, I was at the Viper Room in Los Angeles, and he pulled me on stage, and I came up on my motorcycle, and I was sitting on my motorcycle helmet, and he brought me up on stage and put me in a chair and sang songs to me as he went around stroking my head. And
yeah.
I was like, who is this guy? What?
But you never actually saw Klaus Nomi perform?
No, tonight was the first time I've ever seen any of his stuff, really, besides, you know, the album covers. But it was interesting to see an artist shown in such a personable light, you know what I mean? I think the filmmakers did such a good job. I thought the editing was so nice. I thought the snippets of interviews that they had of his friends, I thought they were the perfect moments were chosen to explain what he was about and what he was like, mostly as a person, you know, making the pies and all the desserts and having fun with his friends was my favorite part of the whole thing.
Yeah. I love the way he did the interviews with a different sort of backdrop that he created for each interview. Interesting.
Yeah, I saw one, there was a guy holding
up.
I sort of caught it at the last
minute. I didn't notice that my first few times of seeing the film.
Yeah, it was really well put together.
From outer space to save the human race. A creature with a dream to entertain the children of the night. The rest, as they say, became history.
Has always been the center of the avant-garde, but every so often some artist comes along who is so, well, out there that even the avant-garde sits up and takes notice.
He was staring at this thing going, what the hell is going on? Does this mean something?
He really seems like a creature from another dimension.
Klaus was on the news. Klaus was with Bowie. Klaus had his face in every magazine.
It got to be nuts. It was a fanatic following.
The Naomi song.
Good evening, hello, and now you have to die.
Remarkable progress.
When I was a kid, I always wanted to be the first in my block with a confirmed kill.
America, good America.
Really, maybe this whole war thing wasn't even true.
I want to get blown up, man. Damn, this just gets better and better.
In the most volatile sector of Baghdad, 400 American soldiers carry out their mission from the ruins of a Playboy's estate built by Saddam Hussein.
We dropped a bomb on it, and now we party in it.
I got a driver's range.
Basically, an adult's paradise.
Ordinary men and women.
19 years old, I fought in a war. Nothing beats it.
Facing an enemy they rarely see.
Oh, if it's anything like last night, it's gonna be ugly, gentlemen.
Now, a war thought to be over.
I'll be back soon, honey.
Has only just begun.
Quiet, all right?
Shut your mouth.
Hey, shut up.
Now, do you
want to
be my guest or do you
want to
be my prisoner?
When we take a dip, we try to stick to the script. But when those guns start blazing and our friends get hit, that's when our hearts start racing and our stomach get woozy. Because for y'all, this is a show. But we live in this movie.
Part of our $87 billion budget provided some secondary armor put on top of our thin-skinned Humvees. It will slow down the shrapnel so that it stays in your body instead of going clean through.
What the news doesn't show you.
Assalamu alaikum.
What the politicians won't tell you.
Really don't like America back here.
Is the truth only the soldiers can bring you.
The guys walk by about trip over themselves. I don't think they ever seen a woman in uniform.
Aim nice and low into the sandbag. You look nervous, you okay?
A lot of stuff can happen here. We're just afraid that no one's gonna know. No one's gonna know the struggle you're going through.
Their country divided, they stand together in a time of war from a place called Gunner Palace.